Slavi has the main value behind them. A lot of people know him in Canada, and to go in there and you know, beat him like you did, you must be pretty satisfied.
Yeah, very satisfied. It was a big deal for me to get my first UFC win. Something I was saying before I even had my last UFC fight was I can't legitimately consider myself a UFC fighter until I get a win. So I got one, although it wasn't the type of exciting fight that I normally like. I mean, it's a win. Now it put me in a position to show some real stuff next time. I wish I could say yeah. Not really. No.
You're still nervous?
Still a little nervous, just because it's a big deal for me to win. I like winning. It's just a competitor in me. It makes me nervous when there's a shot that you might come up short, especially in this sport. But I don't know. Retrospect, I'm happy with it.
So. Some fighters say there's never nerves going into the fight, or just lying. Do you think
for me, yeah. I think there are some psychos out there who don't have nerves, but that's on them. What, the fight? Not necessarily. I didn't really feel like I put him in a position where the ref could justify jumping in to stop it. So.
Vince, given like his name value, who he trains with, practice fighting in Canada, do you think at all about what a favorite he was, or do you guys not even think about that?
I think about that. I hate to admit it, but I think about that stuff a lot, which is all right. I mean, I like being the underdog for the most part. I hate when I'm the favorite. Now I feel like it really puts pressure on me. I look at it much. I don't put much stock into it, but I'm aware of it.
Do you feel like Eamon had a lot more to lose and you had a lot more to gain in this fight?
I did feel like that a little bit, just because he was coming off such a long layoff and where he trains with, the name on him and all that. So, yeah, I felt like he had more to lose. Again, I felt like I was the underdog trying to prove myself. Yeah, I think so.
In what ways?
I like proving myself. I like proving people wrong, so that's just kind of my thing.
What was the vibe in the town? I mean, we're a pretty nice community, but did anyone know that you were fighting Eamon and kind of you're going to get crushed on?
No, nobody was like that at all. It was great. Everybody was really nice. The whole time here, I've had a great time. Everything looked pretty. I mean, I actually like the weather, too. I'm a big fan of the rain, so that was cool. Nice change from Vegas weather lately. Like I said, everybody was real nice. All the staff, the hotel was great. I mean, this whole experience has been awesome.
You mentioned the weather. Vegas, obviously, a lot different. Oregon, I believe.
Yep.
Where would you like to fight next? Would you like to fight closer to home? Are you good fighting internationally?
I'm good internationally, but for the people back home supporting, I know a lot of people want to come show the support live, so if I can get a fight in the States, that'd be great for them. And I love having people there cheering for me. So, July 4th in Vegas, sign me up. Is that International Fight Week? I believe so. Yeah, sign me up for that. I'm in.
That would be your first pay-per-view. Would that make the fight feel bigger and more important?
Definitely. Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. Leave it at that.
I can't remember. Your first fight was on short notice, right? So again, how is it getting to make your full camp debut, as it were?
Kind of neither here nor there. I'm kind of always in camp. I'm always training, always trying to get better. I feel like if I was to get a call next week, I could jump right in there. We stay pretty active in improving, so I'm always ready to jump in.
Plans after the fact? Are you going to go and enjoy the rest of the flights?
Yeah, after I get a beer or six, we'll see.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Is it more likely six or more likely one?
More likely six.
Do you have a choice?
Dos Equis, but I don't know what we got here. I'll try something Canadian and new for me. I'm all about it.
Yeah.